go into yung legal definition under the law of what is money laundering. Now, under our laws, in particular, Republic Act 9160, money laundering is a crime whereby the proceeds of an unlawful activity are transacted, thereby making them appear to have originated from legitimate sources. So, ang ganda ng definition, no? Pinapalabas na galing sa legitimate sources, but actually they are proceeds of an unlawful activity. So, who are the perpetrators of money laundering? Sino bang gumagawa niyan? Of course, the A. No? A, the first person, any person knowing that any money instrument or property represents, invoices, or relates to the proceeds of any unlawful activity. When you say knowing, ikaw mismo alam, alam mo. No, na yung pera na yan, galing sa kidnapping, galing sa droga. And despite knowledge of the source of this money, you consciously, no, or willfully transact or attempt to transact the said monetary instrument or property. Okay? So yun yung first person, no, na can be made liable. Person who has knowledge of the illegal activity. Then after that knowledge, that person transacted, no, or attempted to transact the said monetary instrument or property. Pangalawa, any person knowing that any monetary instrument or property involves the proceeds of any unlawful activity performs or fails to perform any act as a result of which he facilitates the offense of money laundering related to paragraph A. Kanina na-mention natin B, A, na above. Alam mo, no? Alam mo na yung monetary instrument or yung proceeds galing sa illegal activity, wala kang ginawa, no? Or may ginawa ka. But as a result na wala kang ginawa, the activity became successful. Third, any person knowing that any monetary instrument or property is required under this act to be disclosed and filed with the Anti-Money Laundering Council. Dito yung pasok ng mga real estate brokers, no, real estate practitioners. Na alam mo na kailangan i-disclose at saka i-file, no, sa atin sa mga real estate brokers, there's obligation on our part. We'll discuss that later. And yet you fail to do, no? So, may obligation sa iyo na i-mag-file, mag-disclose, hindi mo ginawa yan, then you are liable for money laundering. So, as we mentioned kanina, yung Republic Act number 9160 is the law, no, on anti-money laundering in the Philippines. Now, the first law passed into 2001. And for us to understand well the law, there's a portion there na yung tinatawag nilang covered institutions. So what are covered institutions? No, naka-highlight lang siya diyan, no? Naka-highlight what are the mga grouping. Of course, the first group yung banks. Kasi diyan naman talaga dumadaan normally yung mga pera. No, yung mga pagnanakaw, transfer, sometimes dinadaan sa bangko. So you have banks, non-banks, quasi-banks, trust entities, and all other institutions under subsidiaries and affiliates supervised by or regulated by the Banco Central ng Pilipinas. So banks and other entities, no, performing mga similar banking transactions, they are covered institutions. Kasama na yan, pangalawa, yung insurance companies regulated by the Insurance Commission. Why are they included, no? Yung paggawa ng mga coverage na sobrang mataas na coverage, no? Para ma-park lang yung mga illegal na mga pera nila, no? For example, they want na they'll be insured for 100 million, no? They're willing to pay a premium for that, no? Or mga pension, they park their money to some form of mga pension plans. So, kaya nga covered yung mga insurance companies. Then you have also yung tinatawag na securities dealers. No, security dealers, brokers, salesmen, hindi to mga real estate, ha, na brokers saka salesman. These are mga persons called brokers saka salesmen, but they involved in the sale of yung securities. No, when you say securities, they are common na understanding yan, yung mga shares of stock, equities, no, tinatawag, nagbebenta. Why? Because yung mga ano to, mga criminals may want to invest, no, ostensibly on these mga securities. But actually, yung source ng money nila galing sa illegal activities. Then you have also mutual funds. No, sa third group, mutual funds, closed and investment companies, common trust funds, pre-need companies, or other similar entities. Kasama yan sa covered institutions. You have also foreign exchange corporations, money changers or money payment, remittance and transfer companies, and other similar entities. No, remember, kung magpa-change ka ng mga currencies, nilista yung pangalan mo. No, kasi there are certain thresholds that you'll be reported. Siguro magpa-change ka ng $1,000, $2,000, no? Although na-report mo yan, hindi masyado mainit yan. But for example, nagpa-change ka ng $50,000, $100,000, then that those transactions will have to be scrutinized, no, by government kung saan ang galing yan. Then you have other entities administering or otherwise dealing in currency. Iba yung iba, buy and sell currencies, kasama din yan. Commodities or financial derivatives based on valuable objects, cash substitutes, and other similar monetary instruments. Kunwari nag-hedge ng currency. No? Kunwari, bibili ng ano to, dollar, or di ba, yuan, no? Kunwari, nag-i-invest, but actually yung pera na ginamit is galing sa mga criminal activities. So you have these entities, no, regulated by the Securities and Exchange Commission. These are under the law, covered ng mga groups or institutions. Let's go into yung Declaration of Policy of Republic Act 9160. Now again, ha, these are RA number 9160, giveaway na to, kung just in case this will be asked a board exam. Now, this is the first enabling law on money laundering. This is the Anti-Money Laundering Act of 2001. So what's the reason of the passage of the law? No, yung reason actually, you can find that in the Declaration of Policy. Nakalagay dyan sa batas, the policy of the state to protect and preserve the integrity and confidentiality of bank accounts. Okay, kasi hindi maniniwala na yung mga tao kung yung mga pera na being deposited or parked in banks are coming from criminal activities. So, you have also confidentiality, no? We have yung bank secrecy laws natin. Normally, pinoproteksyonan, no, yung mga persons who are banking, no, because that also preserve, no, yung they want to preserve yung confidentiality because that goes into yung reason ng mga existence ng bank. No, people would like to place their ano to monies in the banks because they know that banks will protect their identities. Then of course, no, yung preliminary discussions natin na yung Pilipinas, one of those na mga persons in the list of non-cooperative countries, yung law actually is part of the compliance, no, of the recommendations of the Financial Action Task Force. Sabi ng Financial Action Task Force of Philippines, magpasa ka naman ng law, no, on anti-money laundering. Kaya nga ito na no to pinasa, Republic Act 9160. So part of our policy, no, foreign policy natin, that the government will extend cooperation in transnational investigations and prosecutions of persons involved in money laundering activities whenever committed. So kung mga dumadaan sa atin, no, na mga pera na hindi ma-explain, yung Philippines will cooperate. No, yung tinatawag nilang transnational investigations. If you remember, di ba, one of the biggest na yung parang ano to, bank transfer, ma-remember nyo. Dito, no, relevant sa atin sa real estate, inamend ng law, no, Republic Act number 11521, yung definition ng covered institutions as part of covered persons. Nag-create ng bagong category yung Republic Act number 11521. Ano yung bagong category? They created a category na yung tinatawag na designated non-financial businesses and professions. Okay? Yung tinatawag na DNFBP. So, a new category as part of yung covered persons. So, why is it important? Because sa number 6 na enumeration, dito sa yung DNFBP, kasama na, sikat na yung real estate brokers and developers. So, if you're working with mga developers, developers are also covered, no, as designated non-financial businesses and professions. Then kasama na rin yan, yung pang-pito, yung tinatawag na offshore gaming operators. Okay? Kasama na yung Pogo. No? Yung mga Pogo operators ng mga, of course, sikat dito is yung mga Chinese. No, yung Mall of Asia area pala class, no? Mga big buildings yan, they're controlled and dominated by Chinese, di ba? Makita nyo? Mga bagong buildings na nakatayo dyan, no? They're being controlled by mga Chinese operators. And many of them are engaged in yung tinatawag na offshore gaming operations. They're supposed to be regulated, no, by the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation or PAGCOR. So covered transaction under, let's go muna sa Republic Act number 9160 para makita natin yung history ng covered transaction. Now, when do you call a transaction covered? When you see covered transaction, ibig sabihin kailangan i-monitor kasi covered siya, no? May obligation to monitor, obligation to document, may obligation to report. So under Republic Act 9160, yung covered transaction under section 3B, no, of that law, it's defined as a single series or combination of transactions involving a total amount in excess of 4 million pesos. Take note, no, under RA number 9160, in excess of 4 million pesos. So kung 4 million, hindi pa siya covered. Ha? Kasi nakalagay sa batas in excess. No, so dapat nakalagay 4,000,001. Basta sumubra ng 4 million, covered na siya. But kung 4 million, it's not covered. Okay? Or an equivalent amount in foreign currency, no, based on the prevailing exchange rate within 5 consecutive banking days. So kung 4 million, pwede mo convert into dollars yan. How much is 4 million in US dollars ba ngayon? 4 million para maging covered transaction. What's the exchange rate natin ngayon? Assuming the exchange rate is 1:54. How many dollars yung 4 million? Anybody? Para may idea tayo sa mga...
Around 72,000. 72,000.
Who's this?
Ay, Jewel, bro.
Ha?
Bugay po, bro.
Miss Bugay, no? 72,000 US dollars, more or less?
Opo, bro.
So yun yung kana, just imagine yung mga transactions kasi normally yun yung currency na ginagamit natin, 72,000 more or less, no? Kung sumobra ka dyan, you're part of a covered transaction if you're dealing in dollars kasi nakalagay dito amount equivalent in foreign currency. Of course, in pesos, dapat more than 4 million. No? So covered siya, it's a covered transaction, pero hindi siya covered, no? Nilagay dyan except those between a covered institution and a person who, covered institution, for example, yung banko, no, and a person who at the time of the transaction was a properly identified client. Okay? For example, properly identified client, sinet up mo yung bank account mo using all the mga government IDs, no? Na-identify ka, may business ka, you're into a profession. Tapos nakalagay dyan, the amount is commensurate with the business or financial capacity of the client. For example, you're a very successful na ano to, na broker, no? Commission mo 5 million, for example lang, no? Or 10 million, sinuerte ka. Sabi niya, exception yon. Basta ikaw, you're a licensed real estate broker. Tapos napakita mo na yung amount is your professional fee. So hindi ka magiging ano to, yung person or the transaction will be ano to, identified as a covered transaction. Why? Because una, you have been properly identified, no, as a licensed real estate broker. Pagkatapos you're able to explain that the amount of deposit, for instance, even beyond 4 million is commensurate, no, with your professional capacity. Sinabi mo, commission ko kasi sa transaction is 5%. So I was able to close a 100 million na transaction, no, and I was being paid 5 million. So magandang type of mga exception. Hindi ibig sabihin sumobra ka ng 4 million automatic na you'll be that will be a covered transaction. There are exceptions, no. And the exception is yung na-mention natin kanina. No, properly identified client and the amount is commensurate with your business or financial capacity. So under ano to, Republic Act number 9160, no, the same din yan, in excess of 4 million pesos. Kasama din yan. Especially cash deposits and investments having no credible purpose or origin, underlying trade obligation or contract. No, for example, pumasok ka sa banko, may bit-bit ka na 5 million, nag-deposit ka, tanongin ka ng banko, sir, saan po nanggaling yung 5 million? Ang sagot mo, hindi, kasi kuan yan eh. No? Inipon ko yan for so many years. No? Tapos magtataka, no? Although you can say na inipon mo yan over the years, but you may be subjected, no, because it may not be credible na you've been saving this money in your residence, pagkatapos after that na umabot ka ng 5 million dineposit mo sa banko. So what took you so long, no, in depositing yung cash? Okay, no, that's really something na it's not good, because for example, you have a current inflation natin ngayon, no? Ano bang current inflation natin ngayon? As reported by ano to, yung National Statistics Office natin, 8% o 9%? Sino pinakamabilis mag-Google dyan?
9%, sir.
O sir, say 9%. No? Who said this 9%?
Bugay, sir.
Mr. Bugay, no? Masipag to si Miss Bugay
Miss
talaga.
Miss Bugay
no?
Po, miss.
Masipag si Miss Bugay. So assuming 9%, after 1 year, with inflation rate of 9%, how much na yung 5 million mo? How much? Assuming na ano to, assuming you have 5 million cash na inipon-ipon mo, assuming totoo yung kwento mo na nag-iipon ka ng cash, tapos with inflation of 9%, after 1 year, yung 5 million mo will be worth? Anybody?
4.550, sir.
Ayan. Oh, so, sino to? Who's this one?
Oliverio po.
Oh, Mr. Oliverio. So, ibig sabihin yung 5 million mo, after 1 year, magiging 4,550,000. Okay? So, mga ganun type of mga hindi ka panipaniwala. Kasi normally, if you have ganun na cash, you better, kung wala ka naman magawa na better, you park it in real estate. Diba? Kasi kahit na paano, the appreciation can offset, no, offset inflation of if it is a well-positioned acquisition, it may even outpace yung inflation. Kaya magiging cases bakit this in relation na hindi siya kapanipaniwala, no, na nagsisave ka ng cash, because normally that will really ano to yung deteriorate, no, in value if you're holding a cash asset. May kasama sa Republic Act number 9160 natin, covered transaction, in excess of 4 million pesos also. No, pareho ata to. Okay. Yan, no? Ayan. Pareho pala yung kanina. So let's go muna sa, pareho lang yung slide na to, no? Yung sa covered transaction. Now let's go dito sa ano to, yung very important na yung amendments. Republic Act number 11521. It amends yung definition of a covered transaction under Republic Act 9160. No, kasi ang dito binaba na yung ano to, yung transaction basta it's cash. So if the transaction is cash or other equivalent monetary instrument, for example foreign currency, binaba na siya to 500,000. So that is already a covered transaction under Republic Act 11521, no, amending Republic Act 9160. Then you have another amendments, yung mga transaction with or involving, take note of the figures class, ha? Kasi these are questions, facts that you'll be asked, no, in the exams. Yung pangalawa, transaction with or involving jewelry dealers. Dealers in precious metals and dealers in precious stones in cash or other equivalent monetary instrument exceeding 1 million pesos. Covered transaction na siya. Ano bang mga jewelry na ano to, no, common, may mga relo ba na more than ano to? Hindi kasi ako mahilig sa luxury eh. May mga relo ba na isang relo na umabot ng mga 2 million, 3 million? Meron na, no?
Meron, Atty.
Oh, so ibig sabihin, bibili ka ng ano to? Yung mga Rolex ba na ganyan? Meron bang mga worth 3 million na relo? 5 million? Meron ba ganyan?
Meron, sir. Meron po.
Meron po.
So if you're, for example, ha?
May mas mahal pa, Atty.
Mas mahal pa, no? Kasi okay. Alam kong mas sobrang mahal yung mga kwan talaga, na mga diamonds, mga gano'n, no? But these are mga watches na super expensive. Hindi mo alam na bumibili ka ng ganyan, covered transaction pala. I-report ka ng jewelry dealers, no? So for example, si Mr. Oliverio, sinuwerte siya, no? Sa kasagot niya sa klase, dami niyang transaction. No? So bumili siya ng ano to? Rolex worth 5 million. So without him knowing, it's a covered transaction na pala siya. Kasi sumobra na yung transaction na 1 million pesos. Now take note, jewelry dealers, dealers in precious metals, dealers in precious stones, mga bato-bato, in cash or other equivalent monetary instrument. So kung tanungin kayo dyan, no, if you use this provision, bumili ka ng, sa mga ladies natin, no, bag na worth 2 million. Di ba mayroong ganun din? Mga ladies? No? May mga bags na ano to?
Hermes.
Oo. Na, what is the most expensive bag ba na ano to? For ladies, meron bang mga tag 10 million? Rare na masyado yan.
Meron po.
Hermes, sir.
Ayan, so, yung not covered. Not covered here, no, because we're talking about mga jewelry pa. Sa taas, cash. Sa ilalim, yung mga jewelry or stones. Kasi normally, kung ang pera mo galing sa nakaw yan, no, nakapag-nakaw ka ng, for example, 50 million, of course, you would buy luxurious items, no? Yung asawa mo, sabihin mo, anong gusto mo? Bili ka ng anong gusto mo dyan, di ba? Kasi easy money. Diba? So, yun yung reason ng batas. O, sino mga bumibili ng ganyan, tapos hindi naman klaro yung ano to, hindi naman reportedly under sa mga listahan ng mga billionaires or the super millionaires, and you're able to afford those ano to mga luxury, then you can be ano to subject to investigation, no? Titingnan niya, no, kasi yan, bumili siya ng relo na ganyan, no? Bumili siya ng mga precious metals na ganyan. So yun yung drawback actually, no, if you analyze yung impact ng itong amendments, no, ng mga co-transaction. Then malapit-lapit na tayo sa real estate. casino cash transaction exceeding 5 million pesos or its equivalent in other currency. Take note, exceeding, no? So 5 million, okay lang. So ibig sabihin, papasok ka sa casino, ensure na yung pinapalit, yung nagpapalit ka ng chips, di ba? Papasok ka ng casino, di ba? You replace yung cash with chips. Huwag sumobra sa 5 million. Kasi, why? Kung sumobra ka sa 5 million, no? For example, nagpa-change ka ng chips, 5 million, one. No, may sobrang piso. Then yung casino has the obligation to report you whether you like it or not. Tatanungin, sir, pakikumpit ka ng form. No? Pero hindi naman sabihin na i-report yung transaction mo. Okay, meron ba susugal dito in this class? No, for the gamblers, ibig sabihin, one at a time, you bring cash sa casino not exceeding 5 million pesos. Now, dito na tayo sa mga profession natin, no, class? Cash transaction with or involving real estate developers or brokers. Take note, hinighlight natin. Real estate developers or brokers. Hindi kasama si salesperson. No, may obligation to report under the law real estate developers or brokers. Yung mga salespersons natin, no, kung wala si broker, normally they work under sa admin ng mga developers, yung si developer may obligation. As long as the cash transaction exceeds 7,500,000 pesos. Act 11521, ang threshold natin is nasa 7.5 million. Cash. Now, of course, kung magaling yung convincing power mo, sir, sabi mo, sir, ano to, next time, pwede bang i-convert mo na, convert mo into MC yan? Now, magkano na naman yung cost magpa-convert ng MC? Magkano?
150.
50 pesos.
Di ba? 50, 100 data, no? Depending on the bank lang, di ba? Ganun yung sistema ng banko yun eh. Kasi di-deposit sa kanila, then pa-issue mo ng MC, ganun. Kung papayag yung kliyente, that would be fine. No? Para wala ka ng headache. Kasi an MC is not a cash transaction. Right? No? Kaya nga tawag sa kanya, manager's check. Of course, kung may personal check, that would have been the easiest part, no? Because antay na yung clearing. So sa atin, sa real estate, ang threshold, and that is very important, no? For you also to prepare sa board exam, kung tanungin, the threshold is more than 7.5 million. The wording is exceeding 7.5 million. So this applies to developers or brokers. So it's really a headache, for example, if your client nagdala ng isang sako. No? Isang sako? Yung isang sako na 50 kilos, ilang million yung pwedeng malagay dyan? Anybody na nakapag-transact na ng isang sako na cash na assuming tago 1,000? Yung 50 kilos na sako ng bigas, kung gamitin mo daw yan, punuin mo siya. How many? Millions ang pwedeng ilagay mo dyan. No? So, may mga ganong type of transaction na cash that would really be a headache. It's a good headache, but it creates an obligation on our part to comply with the anti-money laundering laws. No? So, yung mga developers, may kanya-kanya silang policy. So, as you mentioned, yung employer nyo, parang mga 500,000, may reporting requirement, but there's no obligation pa naman. Developers siguro, they have the in-house, no, policy, basta ganyan, no, they lower the threshold. Nothing will prevent yung mga developers to set that as a policy. But what we're seeing is yung law, ang law, the threshold is 7.5 million. 7.5 million. So, different developers may have different, no, na policies. Sa atin, for example, sa mga brokers, especially for those involved in general brokerage na hindi sila naka-tie up with a particular developer, you have to be very conscious of the threshold requirements under Republic Act number 11-521. Kasi dito mismo sa Republic Act 11-521, kinlaro at saka yung implementing rules and regulation niya, the definition of what is a real estate, no, at saka real estate developer. Kinlaro pero walang lusot. No, so yung real estate, ito yung conventional, traditional definition of a real estate, no? Yung land and other and all those items which are attached to the land. Okay, definition 'yan. For example, ang transaction nyo hindi lupa, bahay. No, covered pa rin siya as real estate because the house is attached to the land. No, it is the physical tangible entity together with all the additions or improvements on, above, or below the ground. The definition of who is a real estate developer? No? Yung employer nyo ba kasama dito? Definition. Of course, kasama. No? It refers to any natural or juridical person engaged in the business of developing real estate development project for his, her, or its own account and offering them for sale or lease. So yan yan, no? So if you're doing that, you are considered as a real developer, then you are bound, no, by the legal requirements under Republic Act number 11-521. Then alam nyo, class, ang definition ng real estate broker lifted lang, no? Lifted lang from the definition of who is a real estate broker under Republic Act 9646, yung RESA law. Andyan, no? Definition. So, of course, this refers to, ano to? This refers to licensed real estate broker. No? So, yun yung mga may obligation ka to make the report, no? As required under yung AMLA natin. Now, of course, yung mga ganitong type of mga situations, no, under AMLA, you have to consider yung mga practical scenarios. You should only be very conscious of the threshold amounts. And take note yung payment na minomonitor are the cash transactions. Cash transactions. So, ibig sabihin kung the payment is in checks, wala tayong problema. Na wala tayong problema diyan, no? Because kung cheque, sino yung nagmo-monitor? Class? Kung cheque, the monitoring or the reporting is transferred to what entity, ano, kaninong entity?
BSP in clearing. Philippine yung, House Clearing pag cheque
po. Yung bangko mismo yung nag-issue ng cheque. 'Di ba? Yung the ano, yung bangko mismo. Hindi transferred na yan from the developer saka broker kasi it will be the obligation of the banks to classify yung mga transactions. No, banking transactions na sumobra ng 500,000. No? Whether you like it or not, those are within the radar na ng ano to, pwedeng i-classify ng bangko. Ito yung mga more than 500,000 na mga transactions, cash transaction. So transferred na from yung obligation to report sa mga bangko, no, if you have if you issue yung check kasi kala natin ano to nakalusot na yung sa atin lang sa brokers saka mga ano to developers if the transaction exceeds 7.5 million doon pa lang nagsiset in yung requirements natin to report. So the challenge really is how to create the right mix, no, na you'll not antagonize yung mga kliyente because these are clients na gustong bumili as well as the requirements of the law. Na siguraduhin din na yung mga monies being used are coming from legitimate sources. Then you have also yung another scenario na involving real estate developers or brokers. No, so ganong type of mga payments, no, you can be very creative about it, no, you may need a very good lawyer in order to structure yung mga transactions, no, could be a very good lawyer or a very good real estate consultant, no, para you'll be compliant with the requirements of AMLA. Then yung ano to, yung interplay ng cash checks na at saka credit. So again, you may need a very good professional to assist, no, para compliant yung transaction. Kung simple lang naman, no, for example, within the malapit sa threshold ng 10 million or 15 million, baka kaya mo nang ano to, no? Doon pa lang sa down payment, you can make a lot of ano to, hedge yan, no, adjustments. 'Di ba? To ensure na hindi siya kahit na willing na magbayad si ano to, si kliyente ng cash, no? For example, 15 to 20 million may cash siya. Ano bang gagawin mo, broker, no? Kayo mismo, salespersons. Do you ask your client? Tanungin mo ba, sir, ma'am, saan ang galing yung legal requirement lang? You have to explain to your ano to, client, sir, meron po tayong Republic Act 11521, baka gusto nyong mag-comply lang tayo. No? So you have to explain. Explain. So instead, pwede pa sir, kasi kung ganyan, no, may mga reportorial requirements po kami, kasi kung hindi namin ma-comply yan, kami naman tatanggalan ng lisensya. Sabihin niya, anong maganda dito? Magbayad lang muna kayo ng ano to. Magbayad lang muna ng today. Magbayad lang kayo muna ng 7.5 million. No? Tapos yung sobra na cash nyo, i-deposit nyo muna yan. Di ba meron tayong good as cash na rin, no? Sa ano to, mga developers. You pay ano to? Ano bang sa inyo? No? For example, sa Ayala. By how much can you stretch na good as cash siya? Anybody? Na good as cash siya?
30 days, sir?
30 days lang ba mabigay nyo?
90 po.
60 days.
90 actually.
Ha?
90 po.
Terms 90 of, days?
90 days po.
Let us say 90 days, no? Pagkatapos ang bit-bit niya is 15 million. So, ibig sabihin, you can stretch yung ano to payment niya to 90 days. No? Kung ayaw niya nang ma-hassle, i-deposit niya na lang yung difference ng 7.5, may maiwan siya na 2.5 every month, magbayad siya ng 2.5 cash. Check na. That could be one, 'di ba? So, ang may obligation to report will not be the broker or the developer, the obligation to report will be sa bangko na. Pero hindi naman automatic na report ng bangko yun eh. Sinasabi lang noon, na ano to, they are within the radar lang ng anti-money laundering. These are mga issues, no, sa practice na kasi maraming tanong, how do you comply with the requirements of yung ano to, yung AMLA. You have also cases of yung mga real estate dealers, no, at saka direct owners. You can all structure those transactions, no, especially you have transactions na ano to, ang kausap mo mismo yung may-ari na, no, not companies, big companies, but ano to, mga those persons involved in the buy and sell, no, of real estate. Then you have also mga professionals, no, like lawyers, real estate consultants and other professionals giving advisory opinions. Okay, so for example, yung ano to, yung transaction, the transactions are being structured by professionals other than brokers. Nakuha nyo, class, yung takbo ng discussion natin. So instead, i-done mo sa broker. But if you want na ano to, na compliant ka with yung anti-money laundering, pwede mo na may daan sa real estate consultant. No, yung transaction. But the transaction will be structured as a consulting engagement. So these are mga tips na mabigay natin, no, practical scenarios involving compliance with yung ano to, yung anti-money laundering laws natin. Then you have also under Republic Act 11521, no, they broaden yung definition of yung suspicious transaction. No, para walang lusot talaga, you can even report yung mga transaction na with covered persons regardless of the amounts involved. Kahit na less than 500,000, basta tingin mo na suspicious. No? Wala namang basis na for example, 200, 300,000 siya, nagbabayad na ganyan because wala naman siya capacity to do that. So these are the circumstances, no, under yung tinatawag nating suspicious transaction. No, walang basis, walang legal obligation, bakit nagkakapera siya ng ganyan. And pangalawa, the client is not properly identified. For example, ang nilagay lang dyan, si Juan de la Cruz. Walang tunay na pangalan. No, so those are mga circumstances na pwede mong elevate yung transaction na suspicious. And the amount involved is not commensurate with the business or financial capacity of the client. So this is for mga law enforcement purposes natin. For example, yung isang nagbebenta ng ano to, for example, banana queue. No, yung front niya is nagbebenta siya ng banana queue. But actually nagiging runner siya ng mga droga. No, or pick up point ng mga droga. So, nagtataka ka, no? Siyempre, siguro kung nagbebenta ka ng banana queue sa isang araw na kita mo, you cannot earn siguro more than 5,000 pesos. 'Di ba, guys? No? Pagkatapos nagtataka ka everyday na ano to na collections niya, dineposit sa banko 100,000, 200,000, no? So that can be escalated or elevated as a suspicious transaction regardless of the amounts involved. Naglagay din sa ng catch-all na definition, no, for purposes of law enforcement. Ayan din nakalagay diyan number 4, no. It taking into account all known circumstances, it may be perceived that the client's transaction is structured in order to avoid being subject of reporting requirements. So, yun yung sa atin, no, sa professional, sa real estate, yung mga reporting requirements. We have an obligation to report. Okay, so yan, number 5, any circumstance relating to the transaction which is observed to deviate from the profile of the client. Kanina, example natin, no, para klaro yung case of nagbebenta ng banana queue. No, tapos daily niya, may collection siya na 100,000. Unless anong klaseng banana ko yung binibenta niya. Lumalabas pala siya kung duwit ng isang drug syndicate. Okay. So, the number 6, the transaction is in any way related to an unlawful activity or offense under this act. Okay, so as long as the transaction involves, no, an unlawful activity, then suspicious na kagad yung transaction na ginawa ng particular person. No? For example, dyan yung ano to, extortion. No? Nag-extort dyan sa mga nagbebenta ng mga stores, no, everyday ng nangungulekta. So that is already considered as a suspicious transaction. Then you have also a catch-all na provision here. Any transaction that is mga analogous, no, to any of the foregoing. Ibig sabihin, yung mga transaction na hindi identified na, not exactly identified, no, sa specifically that similar or analogous. So merong mga ano to, mga cases, no, mga instances of mga unlawful activity. Yung sugal, wetting, example, no. Pamimirata, piracy on the high seas. Siyempre magtatanong tayo, no, ano yung mga identified na unlawful activity, no? Qualified theft, ninakaw mo, swindling, smuggling, no, violation ng Electronic Commerce Act, no, nag-hack ka. Those are considered unlawful activity. Hijacking, no, kasama na niyang arson, murder, fraudulent practices, no, under the Securities Regulation Code, felonies or offenses of a similar nature. No, yung mga punishable under our ano to, penal laws. Then under Republic Act 11521, kasi kanina yung first law natin, no, yung Republic Act 9160. Pagdating sa Republic Act 11521, no, this law amends yung Republic Act 9160 and expand yung definition of unlawful activity. Ano yan? No, mas matindi na yung mga weapons of mass destruction, proliferation of WMD. Sinama na rin siya. No, violation ng National Internal Revenue Code, hindi ka nagbayad ng buwis mo. No, hindi ka nagbayad ng deficiency basic tax. Take note of the threshold amount. Unlawful activity siya as defined under the anti-money laundering law. If the final assessment is in excess of 25 million pesos per taxable year. No, inassess ka ng BIR more than 25 million, considered na rin siya, no, as ano to, unlawful activity. No, penalties. May bilanggo ba dito? No, class, for example, tayo, mga brokers or developers, hindi tayo sumunod. Hindi natin we did not comply with the reportorial requirements. You can be prosecuted and ano to, penalized with imprisonment from 7 to 14 years. No, yung pagkakabilanggo, 7 to 14. Then may multa, no, fine of not less than 3 million pesos. But not more than twice the value of the money instrument or property involved. No, hindi so sobra sa doble. So you have 7 to 14, you have 4 to 7. Huh? So depending on yung, if you're convicted under section 4B. Hindi ka naman yun yung 4A, ikaw yung sikat, no? The principal, yung 4B, tinulungan mo lang siya. That's 4 to 7. Then, sa penalties for brokers saka property developers. Okay? Ano nakalagay dyan? 6 months to 4 years or a fine of not less than 100,000 but not more than 500,000. For ano to? For violation of section 4C. Okay? So, ito lang. Ito isipin natin. No? That ends our presentation on yung anti-money laundering law. Specifically, yung amendatory law, which is Republic Act 11521, with respect to mga real estate professional practice.